Welcome back, everyone, to my channel. I'm glad you're able to tune in again. That means you really enjoy the other videos. Today I am just basically here to talk to you about my purpose, as I want to give you an understanding of where I'm coming from and what I want to do with this channel. I hope you really enjoy this as I dive into my position as a Black person in society who has a voice and wants to use it as an instrument to find a way to resolve all of the tensions that we experience in everyday life. I am Black, as you can tell. So my main focus is going to be on my experience as a Black body, as I can only talk about my experience. I can't really put the experience of another onto my story. So although I want to be very open with everyone, it's mostly going to be my experience as a Black person in a Canadian society, responding to the negative stuff that I've been quietly holding in as I watch it unfold. The one thing that has shaped my growth throughout my experience with getting woke, has been my university experience. And that's because the school I went to has a very diverse curriculum where you just have to meet certain requirements and everything else is up to you. So I took the opportunity to focus on my Black heritage. I took African literature, Caribbean literature, post-colonial studies. I took diaspora literatures, theater of the Holocaust, and courses that basically reflect the oppression that I had to endure and that other people had to endure. And reading these texts really opened my eyes to the various magnitudes of trauma that different people can experience, such as Indians and Japanese people and African people, just everyone in a melting pot because of how diverse the course was. It just made it very great to see that you're not alone, and different cultures, no matter where you come from, all experience trauma. And it really helped me realize that in order to bypass all of this trauma is to, you know, get together and unite, you know. And I know it sounds very optimistic, but I really do feel like if we all just came together and said, hey, you know what, I see that you're different, but you have the same goals as me, or I see that you're different, and although our goals aren't the same, let us just live together and be okay. And I feel like once everybody agrees on that, we can, you know, live peacefully. But I don't know. The more and more I get older, the less and less I believe in that. But I am trying to keep the faith because I really do believe that if we all just get along, there wouldn't be any issues. But everybody's just greedy and jealous and insecure. And that's where all of the conflict comes because, and I don't mean everybody, but I just mean certain people in society that govern it create these opportunities for conflict when there doesn't need to be, and it really frustrates me. I feel like I'm a very smart and intellectual person, so I'd also like to be able to provide advice and give ideas on my perspective, because I have been known to give really good advice, and I have really good thoughts once I'm able to convey them. That's something I really do want to work on, is being articulate, because I've been having a very hard time just trying to put the words into what I want to say so that people can understand me. But hopefully through talking out loud more often and taking part in this channel, I'll be able to be more articulate, because that would very much help me in my teaching position, because the students will see, oh yeah, she's an intellectual. She's not just saying things, you know, no. But I don't know. On this channel, I really want to start discussing the texts that I've read that have brought me to this position where I feel very confident in recognizing, hey, this is wrong, or hey, like, this is set because there are structures that are hindering people from getting to one place to another. And so I think most of the focus will be on the text that I've read, and not an analysis, but basically a summary of them and why they are so significant to me, and why it has impacted me. And that may give you an opportunity to want to read it or just listen to what I have to say. Either way, I'm getting it off my chest, which makes me feel good, because I feel like in my university experience, like, although we had an opportunity to discuss the material, I didn't get everything I wanted out in those moments. So I felt a little, what is that feeling when, like, you, incomplete, I felt incomplete, like, I just wanted to say more, so now I have an opportunity to do so. So I want to be focusing on books, as well as I do have a hair journey that I mentioned earlier, where I want to have you all be a part of it, where once my natural hair is out and flourishing, like on wash days or when my hair was slicked back, I want, like, to get your comments and show you, like, how I've been able to begin my natural hair journey. So all my life, I was perming my hair up until last year, where I decided to grow it out and then cut off the permed hair. And now I'm officially 100% natural. So I want to have you explore the ups and downs that I've had on my natural hair journey. But mostly it has been ups. Like, the only downs that I've had so far, like, I'm 4C hair. So when I do the wash and go, like, when it dries, it just looks very chaka-chaka. And I don't like that. But other than that, like, I've loved it. Like, when my hair is wet, when my hair is slicked, it's just, I love it. The only thing that I need to figure out how to manage is how to deal with it when it's dry, because when it's dry, that's when the knots start to form, and that's when it becomes complicated. But overall, I really do, like, love my natural hair journey, so that's something I really do want to have being put into the channel. So I really hope you enjoyed this video this week, as it did basically outline the direction I do want to take this channel into. And I hope you will follow me on this journey as I try to unpack the societal structures that are enabling us to be hindered, as well as to explore the beauty in being who you are and accepting everything, flaws and all. Until next week. Oh, I may be like a supermodel, but I learned to love myself unconditionally.